Hey guys, starting with a chapter called Rectilinear Figures. We also call this chapter as polygons in some of the textbooks. Polygons, yes. Five formulas, English aana chahiye. Simple English, yeah, simple English. Five formulae, simple English, and thode basics of 6th, 7th and 8th standard of geometry. If you know these three things, you will love this chapter. Yeah, exactly. What up? Let's begin with the chapter called polygons or rectilinear figures. A simple chapter. I can expect or assume one or two questions max in the test of your school from this chapter. Okay, five formulae. But before I teach you the formulae, we need to understand a few figures, right? Yes, we have a triangle. We have a four-sided figure, which is a quadrilateral. We have a five-sided figure, which is called a pentagon. A six-sided figure, which is called a hexagon. And then it goes on. So N stands for the number of sides. What is N for? Number of sides in a figure. So if N is 3, we call it as a triangle. N is 4, quadrilateral. N is 5, pentagon. Come on. Pentagon aana chahiye na yaar. N is 6, hexagon. Okay, this see everyone knows. N is 7, we call it as, it's not sept, it's hept. Heptagon. When N is 8, we call it as octopus, octagon. When N is 9, it is nonagon. And when N is 10, it is decagon. Ab bas itna enough. 11. Okay. There is something called as hendecagon, and it goes on here. I am not interested in that. Okay. So this is how the things are. 10 tak you should know ideally. And we have a formula. 5 formulae which you have to buy hard. First one. The first formula states sum of all the exterior angles is always going to be 360. Ratta maar. Sum of all the exterior angles, bahar wale angles. Okay, when you add all the angles, sum of all the exterior angles, okay, jo bhi hai, it's going to be 360. Exterior matlab bahar wale angles. Each exterior angle, each ka answer matlab 360 upon the number of sides. Total is 360, each ka answer is the same answer upon n. That is each ka answer. Sum of all interior angles is n minus 2 into 180. And if I am asking you the formula for each interior angle, it is the same formula upon n. You just have to divide it by the number of sides. You get each ka formula. And the last formula, exterior angle plus interior angle is always going to be linear pair, 180. Obviously each exterior angle plus each interior angle, if you add both of them, you are going to get the answer as 180. Remember this. Okay, so five formulae, by heart it. We start with the first sum without wasting time. Come on. Sum of interior angles of a polygon is 4 times sum of exterior angles. Main katha likhunga, katha, story. I write English. I'm going to first write English. Listen, they are saying sum of exterior is 4, sum of interior is 4 times sum of exterior. I just write English. Sum of interior is 4 times sum of exterior. चल, sum of interior का formula is n minus 2 into 180. इसका मतलब equal to 4 times का मतलब multiplication. Sum of exterior is 360. Here I have written sum of exterior, sum of interior formula. You can say 180 नीचे जाएगा, multiplication becomes division. Direct cut करना, 2's are. So n minus 2 is equals to 8. So n is equals to 8 plus 2. It is a 10-sided figure, it is a decagon. पूछा नहीं है, just for your reference. So simple, yeah. Just English, convert it to mathematics. That's it. Second question. The angles of a pentagon are in the ratio 4, 8, 6, 4, 5. Find each angle of a pentagon. Okay, guys. जब भी ratio देते हैं, let the common multiple be x. So, no need of a diagram, just for my convenience. So, let common multiple be x. Let the common multiple be x. ठीक है ना? Right. So I can say, since the common multiple is x, one ratio is 4, 5, 4, 6, 8. So 8x, 4x, 5x, 4x and 6x. ठीक है ना? Now can I say, जब मैं सबको add करूंगा, look at me. When you add all of them, isn't it sum of अंदर वाला, English लिख, write down English. It is sum of interior angles. That's what I'm going to use. Sum of interior angles, the formula is n minus 2 into 180. So just add them, na? They are inside. 4x plus 5x plus 6x plus 8x plus 4x is equals to, n is 5. 5 minus 2 into 180. This is going to be 10, 19, 27x. Is equal to 5 minus 2, that makes it 3 into 180. Get the 27 down. Nine threes are, nine twenties are. X ka answer 20 milega. You just substitute 5 into 20, 100. 4 into 20, 80. 160, 120. Just substitute and get all the individual angles in a pentagon. Okay. The next question, question number, which one? Third. Okay, the question is, one angle of a six-sided polygon is 140, others are equal. No need of a diagram, I'll just make it to make things clear for you all. One angle is 140 and the rest are equal. Let each of the remaining angle be x. Let each of the remaining be x. And जब मैं सबके अंदर वाले को add करूंगा, in English I will say it is the addition of internal angles. Can I say it is sum of interior angles? The formula remains the same. Okay. So I will say 140. Plus x plus x plus x plus x plus x, that makes it 5x. N is 6. Yeah, n is 6 because it's a hexagon. So I get 5x. 4 into 180 is 720. Okay, 4 into 18, 18 fours are 72. So 5x is equals to 580. X is equals to 116 degrees. Therefore, each of the remaining angle, each of the remaining angle of the hexagon is 116 degrees. So go through this and then we shall proceed with the next set of questions. Okay, going on to the fourth question. The fourth question was, in a polygon, there are five right angles. There are five right angles. Yeah. And the remaining angles are 195 each. Find the number of sides of a polygon. Mark this as the first important and a slightly difficult question. Listen, there is a random polygon. I don't know kitne sides hai. We don't know. N is question mark. Number of sides, question mark. But we know, let there be n sides and let there be n angles. Obviously, if there are n sides, there are n angles. N mein se 5 are 90 each. 90, 90, 90, 90, 90. 5 angles are 90 each. So can I say 5 are 90 degree each. So obviously out of total n, if 5 are gone, 5 angles are gone, nikal gaye, the remaining angles are n minus 5 and they are 195 degrees each. Achha, now if you, these are all interior angles, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 195, 195, 195, 195 and so on. So if you add them, is it in English, can we say sum of interior angles? Sum of interior angles. Yes. So sum of interior angles, the formula is n minus 2 into 180. This is the formula of sum of interior angles. So it's going to be sum of interior angles means those addition, 5 into 90 plus n minus 5 into 195 is n minus 2 into 180. Yeah, this is the addition of all the interior angles and this is the formula. So you get 450. Open the bracket. N into 195. 5 into 195. N into 180. 2 into 180. Get N on this side. You get 195N minus 180N is 975, goes on the other side, plus minus 360 minus 450. So 15N is 165. So the number of sides are 13. So 13 sides, out of which 5 are 90 and the remaining 8 sides are 195. Mark this as a star sum. Okay, the next question is pretty simple. Three angles of a seven-sided polygon are 132 each. 132, 132, 132. And the remaining four are x. X, x, x and x. So when you add, it is sum of interior angles. All you have to do is use the formula. So I want you to try this sum by yourself. Yeah. So I'll just make it a simple note. 132 into 3, because there are three angles. And there are, let each of the remaining angle be x, so 4x, and this is nothing but sum of interior angles, put n as 7, you will get the value of x. So try this sum by yourself. 6 is also same, we will solve it. Two angles of 8 sided polygon are 142 and 176. And remaining 6 are equal. Let the common multiple be x. So the remaining are 6x. You add all of them. Nah? X plus x plus x plus x plus x plus x. If you add, it is going to be 6x. So when you add them, you get sum of interior angles. And the formula is n minus 2 into 180. Same. You have to add the andar wala angles. So you get 142. Plus 176 plus 6x. Instead of n, you put 8. Okay. Solve this. 278, 288, 298, 308, 318 plus 6x. 6 into 8. 18 6s are. Okay, let it be as of now. 8 6s are 48. 48. 6 1s are 6. 1080 is 318 plus 6x. Shift. 6x is equals to 1080 minus 318. Carry forward to 7. 7 minus 1, 6, 10, 762. So you get x as 1, 2, 7, 127 degrees. So each of the remaining angle is 127. Okay, seventh question, mark it as an important, second important sum. The first important sum is the fourth one. And the second one is seventh. Check. In a pentagon ABCD, E, AB is parallel to DC. So first, AB and DC are parallel. That is the condition to be satisfied. So if I name AB, synchronization mein hona chahiye. ABCD, so you'll have to join it. ABCD mein AB and CD are parallel. So obviously E will be somewhere out here. Pentagon. Ratio of AED. Ratio of AED is 3. Ratio means common multiple. Okay, now do you know that since the lines are parallel, this angle plus this angle is 180, C formation, co-interior angles. So B plus C has to be 180. It doesn't mean they both are 90. No, this can be 60, this can be 120 also. This can be 50, this can be 130, but their addition is 180. Because if lines are parallel, 7th and 8th, we have studied geometry, co-interior, allied angles. This plus this, 180. Sum of interior angles, 2. So, same way, let's start with the English. Sum of interior angles, the formula is n minus 2 into 180, add all of them, 3x plus 4x plus 5x plus angle B plus angle C, sum of 5 angles, there are 5 angles, n is 5 because it is a pentagon. So if you add them, you get 12x plus 180 is equal to 3 into 180, 540. Shift. You get 540 minus 180. The answer is going to be 360. 12x is equal to 360. So obviously get the 12 down. You get x is equal to 30 degrees. And once you get x, angle A is 3x, which is 90. Angle B is, B name, D, is 5x, which is 150. And angle E is 4x, which is 120 degrees. So we respectively find the three angles. Okay guys, go ahead with these sums, these four questions. Then we'll start with the sum number 8, which is still an important sum. Hey guys, moving on to the next chapter, sum. The question is a wonderful question, 8 questions, star mark. Mark it as a star sum. 4th was a good question, number 4, and now it's 8. The question is, A, B, B, C and C, D are 3 consecutive sides of a regular polygon. Please underline the word regular polygon. Sun. Regular means all sides are equal and each interior angle is the same. Nahi samjhana? Batata hu. Look, if I make a polygon, an open polygon, I don't know how many sides it has, I don't know. Regular means all sides are equal and each interior angle is the same. X, 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 X. Let me call it as X. This is the significance of a regular polygon. Now, I have been told we have, let's say, A, B, C, D and goes on. Kidhar tak band hoga, where it closes, I don't know how many sides it does have. Yehi to dhoondna hai. I have to find the number of sides. Okay. Angle BAC. B, A and C. This one. This angle is 15 degrees. Now can I say this triangle BAC is an isosceles triangle? Triangle back is an isosceles triangle. So base angles are equal. If this is 15, obviously this will also be 15. So angle BCA is equal to angle BAC. It has to be 15 degrees for a simple reason. Base angles of an isosceles triangle is same. Iso triangle base angle. Short of it. First step. Second, angle sum property. Sum of all three of them, that is x plus 15 plus 15 is 180. ASP, angle sum property. Tino ka addition is 180. So x is equal to 30 udhar jayega, 150 degrees. Ask yourself a simple question. What is x in this figure, in this diagram? What is x? X is each interior angle. Nahin samajh raha hai? Isn't it andar wala, inside, interior angle, one interior angle, each interior angle. So x is each interior angle. So I will say, therefore, interior angle, it is 150 degree. Do we know one formula? Formula number 5. Exterior angle plus interior angle, when you add them, it comes to 180 degree. So exterior angle plus interior angle is 150, it is 180. So exterior angle, can I write it as 30 degrees? Now when nothing is mentioned, it has to be each. Please, it is not sum. So exterior angle means each exterior angle, one exterior angle. One. The formula for exterior angle, each exterior angle, is 360 upon n. N shift cross multiply, you get 36 by 3. It is a 12-sided polygon. It's a 12-sided polygon. So, question asks, how much is each interior angle? 150. How much is each exterior angle? 30. And what are the number of sides? 12. That's it. Hendecagon. Not asked. Number of sides is 12. That's it. Nice, very, very beautiful question. This was your question number 8. Mark it as a star sum. Proceeding with the 9th sum. Ratio between exterior and interior angle is 2:3. Very simple. I break English to maths. Ratio means something upon something. Ratio of exterior angle, that's an angle, to interior angle is 2:3. Now when nothing is mentioned, please, by default, each wala formula use karne ka, each, cross multiply. 3 times the exterior angle is equal to 2 times the interior angle. Are cross multiply, yaar, 9th standard student. Exterior angle formula 360 upon n. Interior angle formula n minus 2 into 360 upon, oh my bad, 180 upon n. Cancel where possible. n goes, 2 into 180, 360 goes. So you are left with 3 is equals to n minus 2 shift. Number of sides is 3 plus 2, 5. Finish, game over. Checkmate. N is equal to 5. So it's a pentagon. 10th. Oh, 10th, mark it as a star sum. Which are good questions? Number 4, number 8 and number 10. 3 good questions till now. 10th question is, the difference between an exterior angle of n minus 1 and n plus 2 sided polygon, regular one, is 6 degree. English, aana chahiye. Look at this. Difference. Difference means subtraction. Kiska difference? Between exterior angle, which is 360 upon n, but the number of sides is not n. The number of sides is n minus 1. So the difference between the exterior angle, jiska formula is 360 upon n, but number of sides is not n, it is n minus 1. And 360 upon n plus 2, this difference is given to me as 6 degrees. Exterior angle 360 upon n, n is not the number of sides, it says it's n minus 1. You take common, you take a 360 common, so 1 upon n minus 1, 1 upon n plus 2 is 6. You can reduce 6 ones are and 6 60s are. So 60 cross multiply LCM. N minus 1 into n plus 2 cross multiply n plus 2 minus sign, so signs will change. Be cautious. Students make a mistake out here. It will be minus n minus n minus plus 1. They write minus 1. So the answer is going to be 60 into 2 plus 1, 3 cross multiply n minus 1 n plus 2. 180, this is going to be n square plus 2n, open the bracket, minus n minus 2. So 180 is equals to n square plus n minus 2, shift. 0 is equals to n square plus n minus 2 minus 180 minus 182. Splitting up of middle term, quadratic equation, factorization chapter. Product. 182, sum mein 1 chahiye, 14 threes are, try, 14 into 13, 4 threes are 12, 3 ones are 3 and 1 4, 140, 1 half, it's 14 and 13. So n square plus 14n minus 13n minus 182 is 0, n bracket n plus 14, minus 13 common bracket n plus. Minus common, andar ka sign changes. Don't forget the basics. So n plus 14, n minus 13 is 0. Ya to n minus 14 milega, ya to n 13 milega. Sides of a triangle or any polygon cannot be negative. So minus 14 is discarded. So my answer for number of sides in this given question is 13 sides. Okay, a very nice question. It's one of my favorite sums. Third, good question. Last question from the A exercise, the 11th question. Mark this also as a star sum. Important. The question is, two alternate sides of a regular polygon are produced meeting at right angle. Okay, it's an open polygon. Regular, all sides are equal. Okay, two alternate sides. Alternate means 1 and 3 or 2, 4 or 3, 5. Okay, two alternate sides are produced Let's produce 2 and 4. Produce. They meet at right angles. Let's say this is A, B, C, D, and let's say this point is M, B, M, C, hopeless. Yeah, B, M, C. So, this is a right angle triangle. It's a regular polygon, so each interior angle, this is an interior angle, please, is the same. Okay, guys, this is a linear pair. There is some geometry involved out here. This is a linear pair. Oh, matlab, this plus this is 180, straight line. So wouldn't this be 180 minus x? Yeah, that MBC, angle MBC is 180 minus x, linear pair. Even this angle, according to a linear pair, this is also 180 minus x, which is angle MCB. Miniature circuit breaker, masti kar raha, MCB. Acha, in this triangle BMC, can I use angle sum property? So in triangle BMC, 180 minus x plus 90, which is angle M, plus 180 minus x, it is equal to 180, which is sum of measures of all angles in a triangle is 180. Right? 180 cut. 180 plus 90, 270 minus x minus x. So 270 is equal to 2x, shift. X is 270 divided by 2, which is 135 degree. Isn't x? X hai kya? Hai kya? X is interior angle. Oh, wow. It is each interior angle, that is your x according to the diagram. And then I can use the same formula. Each exterior plus each interior is 180. Exterior angle plus interior angle, which is 135, is 180. So the answer of exterior angle will be 180 minus 135, 45 degrees. You get each exterior angle. And question mein they are asking you, find also the number of sides. Number of sides, come on. Each exterior angle ka formula is 360 upon n. So 45 is 360 divided by n. You get n ka answer as 8 on solving on cross multiplication. It is actually this only. Same sum. Question number 8 and question number 11 ka workout layout is exactly transcendental, exactly similar to each other, very much similar. So I can say I found out interior angle, which is x, and exterior angle is 180 minus x, bahar ka angle, and using exterior angle ka formula I find out the number of sides, same as 8th question. So a exercise mein, if you happen to analyze, 4 questions are very nice questions. 4th, 8th, 10th, 11th. Go through these 4 questions very, very precisely, very in a very focused manner. Baki ke sare to answer. B exercise. First question we are not going to solve. It's a true-false question. We are starting with the second question. Yes. It's a diagrammatic question. Simple. Abhi sara geometry involved hai. Geometry. Yes. Okay. So let's begin. A diagram is given to me in the second question. I draw U diagrams and my solving will be within the diagrams. Okay, diagram may solve kar dunga. So we have A, B, it's a parallelogram, D and M. Parallel. Prove that angle M is 90 degree. We need to prove this. Question it is given, AM is angle bisector. Angle bisector means angle ko do equal parts mein divide karega. That means if this is x obviously this will also be x. It is an angle bisector. DM is also angle bisector. If this is y, this will also be y. Same, na? Angle ko do equal parts mein, it's going to divide it. Alright. Guys, have you heard about C formation? Are in this chapter only I told you, in one of the sums. C formation mein, pentagon wala sum tha, I remember. C formation mein, you remember that this plus this is going to be 180. This entire plus this entire co-interior angles, allied angles, it's going to be 180 degrees. Nice. So can I say angle D plus angle A is 180 degrees? Reason is co-interior angles. So if you observe 2y plus 2x is equals to 180 according to the diagram, divide by 2. Divide by 2. Har ek term ko 2 se divide karo. X plus y is 90. Dividing each term by 2. Alright. Now, talking about the triangle Adam. Are ADM. So, in triangle Adam, can I say y plus x plus angle M has to be 180? Angle sum property. But, what is x plus y? Isn't x plus y 90? So 90 plus angle M is 180. Shift. Hence proved. Angle M is going to be 180 minus 90. We have proved that M is a right angle. Wonderful question. We use co-interior concept and we use the angle sum property. These are angle bisectors. You get M as 90 degrees, right? Let's go on with the next question, the third question. Again, a question which can be solved using a diagram only. Okay, a diagram is given to me this way. It's given that this side is equal to this side is equal to this side, and we have fine. This is what we have. Question mein bola hai, angle A is 102. This is 102 degrees. Let's find everything on this earth. Construction, my friends. Construct ED. Sorry, EC. I didn't see that. Such that it is parallel. So basically, this becomes a parallelogram. Construct EC parallel to AB. So construct EC parallel to AB. Therefore, EC is equal to AB because in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal, my friends. Yes, yes. Oh my God. AB is equal to EC. Aha, aha. ये बन गया मेरे दोस्तों. So my friends, मित्रों, this becomes an equilateral triangle. So obviously this is 60, 60, 60, right? Okay. Now, have you learnt this concept that in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal? Parallelogram में opposite angles are equal. So this is 102. Okay. I think this is a C formation. This also and this also. We just did. C formation mein addition has to be 180. So this is going to be 180 minus 102. 78. C formation. Co-interior angles. So opposite angles are equal. 78. Sum is over. Question mein poocha hai, find AEC. AEC is 78. And they are asking me BCD. BCD is 102 plus 60. and that is going to be 162. That's it. So, acha, in school exam, you'll have to mention the reasons. Okay, opposite sides are equal, it's a parallelogram. So, this will be my actually step number 2. Main idhar hi aise likhunga, I'll write this way. 2 means that is what I did next. First, 102, 102. This was my step number 1. Opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. Step number 2, it is an equilateral triangle, hence 60. Step number 3 was this step. Ye mera third step tha, that was your co-interior angles, C formation, and this was my step number 4, opposite angles in a parallelogram are equal. So, aage jaake, I'll make big diagrams, and within the diagram, I write 1, 2, 3, 4, which will make you understand that sir did this first, then sir went to this step, and main reason bhi likhunga. So, all you have to do is just write in a statement form. I'm showing it to you in diagram form. Right? Fourth question. Fourth is a flamboyant sir. Ah, beautiful question. Flabbergasting. Fourth question, man. I have been told, which color do I use? Yellow. A square ABCD is given to me. Okay, so we have a square ABCD. Okay. Diagonals meet at O. The two diagonals meet at point O. Such that OB is equal to BP. And there is a point P on BC. P hai na P? Kidhar to hai? Kidhar? I don't know. But somewhere on BC. Let's say P is out here, such that OB is equal to BP. OB and BP are equal. I drew OP. Okay? Ye diya hai. This is all what is given. Now we start with our show. Let's begin the show, my friends. In a square, each angle is 90. That's my first step. Okay, so first step, each angle is 90 degrees in a square. Step number 2, diagonals bisect the angle. That's a rule. That's a rule actually for a square. Diagonals break it into two equal angles. 45, 45, and so on. Fine. Third, I can use isosceles triangle. My second step will be, look, these two sides are equal. When these two sides are equal, it is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles mein base angles equal honge. Let me call this as XX. So this is my step number 2. Base angles of isosceles triangle. So I can calculate X plus 45 has to be 180. Angle sum property. Statement 3. So 2x is equal to 135, yeah, obviously minus hoga. So x is 67.5. This is my value of x, which is BOP. So angle BOP, BOP, which is x, it is 67.5. Next step, I know ke diagonals meet at 90 degrees in a rhombus as well as a square. This complete package is 90. Complete package, that is BOC. So I can say angle BOC can be written as BOP plus POC. So 90 is equals to 67.5 plus angle POC shift. 90 minus 67.5 is angle POC. Therefore, angle POC on calculation gives 22.5, which is 22.5. Okay, nice. What is asked first? POC found out. BDC, BDC, which is 45. Angle BDC is 45. 45 can be written as 2 into 22.5. Beautiful. Look at the thought now. Superb. BDC is 45. 45 I broke. Toda. 2 into 22.5 because 22.5 is POC. So can I write 2 into 22.5 ke jagah pe POC? Hence proved. The next one is BOP. Angle BOP. BOP is X. 67.5. 67.5, can I write it as 3 into 22.5? Who is 22.5? POC. So 3 angle POC. Hence proved. Right? So go through these questions. By writing the numbers, you will come to know that which is my first step, which is my second step. Next question. Question number 5. Beautiful question. All questions are nice. Chal. Okay, a square is given to me. Okay. An equilateral triangle. This joins the diagonal. And this joins out here. This is the diagram. We have D, C, P, A, O, P. Okay, I have been told that ABP is an equilateral triangle. Three sides are equal. And it's a square also, ABCD. So basically all sides are equal. Let's say if this is 6 cm, 6 cm, 6, 6, 6, 6. Everything is 6. All sides are equal. Since it is a square, each angle will be 90. Okay. Second thing, in a square, ye diagonal nahi hai. This is a diagonal. Yes. So I can say 45, 45 like the previous sum. Diagonals break the angle into two equal parts. Be cautious what I am doing here. 45, 45. Pura, pura. Yeah. Okay. Andar wala is an equilateral triangle. So this has to be 60. This has to be 60. So itna 30 ho jayega. Are yaar, see properly. This is 45. This is 60. 45 is still the diagonal. This bigger one is 60. So 90 minus 60, 30. Beech wala 15 ho jayega, not needed. This is also 60. Okay. Now what? Angle sum property. 60 plus, I want this angle. 60 plus this angle, let me name it as A, plus this much, 45 tak jata hai. 60 plus A plus this much, 45 is 180. A milega. So, A plus 105 is 180. A will be equal to 75. So, A is 75. This is an isosceles triangle. Two sides are equal. So, if two sides are equal, the base angles are equal. So, I can say again, x plus 30, this one, 30 is 180, 2x is 150, x will be 75. So basically this smaller version is going to be 15 degrees because this is 75. Finish. What is asked? Angle AOB. AOB is small a, which is 75. Angle BPC. BPC is this x, which is 75. PCD. PCD is 15. I found out actually everything. Jo nahi bhi zarurat tha, I found out, because your concept should be clear. Sixth question. Okay, sixth question mein the diagram goes this way. This is the diagram. It's given A, B, C, D and E. This is given as 67. It's a rhombus. All sides are equal. And upper wala is an equilateral triangle. Basically everything is equal. Now, A, B, C, D is a rhombus. Rhombus is a parallelogram. Rhombus is a type of parallelogram. So opposite angles are equal. This is a statement number one. In a rhombus, opposite angles equal because it is a type of a parallelogram. Also, they are upper wala is an equilateral triangle. 60, 60, 60. Statement number two. Okay, isn't this going to be a C formation? Because rhombus is a parallelogram. C formation. So, my co-interior angles, this is co-interior third step. 180 minus 67. 180 minus 67, 113. 113 के 123, 113. ये भी सेम. Opposite angles in a parallelogram are equal. Okay. Now what? Now I can turn my head and I can see this is an isosceles triangle. Two sides are equal. If two sides are equal, their base angles are equal. Yeah. So can I call this small e as x? X. So 60 plus 67 plus 2x, angle sum property. That will be my fourth step. So in triangle ECB, x plus 60 plus 67 is equals to 180. 2x plus 127 is equals to 180. 2x is equals to 53. X is 53 divided by 2, which is 26.5. Okay, x I got as 26.5. Anything else? Anything else is given or what? Kuch nahi diya hai yaar. Okay. Now what? In a rhombus, diagonal will bisect the angle. It's a property. In a rhombus, diagonal bisects the angle. So 113 will be divided into, that is 113 divided by 2, 56.5, 56.5, 56.5, 56.5 and 56.5.
Oof.
Okay. What is asked in the question? First, angle CBE. CBE, which is X, 26.5. Second, what is asked? DBE. DBE, 56.5. That's it.
Beautiful question.
Going on with the seventh question. Seventh is very easy. Pura nahi kar raha hu. It's a simple sum. A parallelogram is given to me. Okay. In a parallelogram, 6y plus 2, 4x. 4y and 3x minus 3. Can I say in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal? So 4x is equal to 6y plus 2, shift. 4x minus 6y is equal to 2. Equation 1. 4y is equal to 3x minus 3, shift. 4y minus 3x is equals to minus 3. Solve the two equations simultaneously, get x and y. I hope you know how to solve simultaneously. Ek bar x aur y mila, isme dalo, you will get the sides of a parallelogram. So seventh wala, please try by yourself. This is seventh ka first. Seventh ka second is also the same. Okay, I'm just giving you a hint. 6x plus 3y minus 8. 4x plus 20. 7y. It's a parallelogram. Okay, in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So you can say 6x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 7y. Shift the y on this side. 3y minus 7y is minus 4y. 8 udhar wo side. Equation 1. And second equation, you can use a C formation. See? C. Parallel lines mein tumhara thumb and last finger hona chahiye. Parallel lines. So, this plus this is 180. So, 4x plus 20 plus 7y is 180. You will get second equation. Solve them simultaneously. Co-interior angles. So, seventh wala, please try by yourself. It was easy. Go through this. Last three sums for the B exercise to end. Okay, guys. Last three questions for this exercise. Eighth. The angles of a quadrilateral are in the ratio 3, 4, 5, 6. Show that it is a trapezium. Very simple. It's a quadrilateral. So if you add all the angles, it's 360. So let the common multiple be equal to x. Currently, I'm not saying it's a trapezium. No. 3x, 4x, 5x and 6x. Just random. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Just add them. Yeah. 3x plus 4x plus 5x plus 6x is 360. So 18x is 360. X is 20. So this is going to be 60. This is 120, this is 120, this is 80, my bad. And this is 5 into 20, 100. Okay, so ideally, can I say that two angles ka addition and two angles ka addition is 180. It becomes a C formation. And if it is a C formation, yes, the figure is a trapezium. Ideally, 80 upper ana chahiye, 120 niche ana chahiye. So 6x will come down. This is just a rough figure. I know you haven't understood. Listen. 60 and 120, when you add them, doesn't it become 180? 80 and 100, when you add them, can I say the sum of two interior angles is 180? So by co-interior ka converse, lines are parallel. Co-interior ka converse. Why converse? Because we got the answer of addition as 180. 180 aaya by solving geometry. And because of that, I can see lines are parallel. Okay, so it's a trapezium. Ninth question. In a parallelogram ABCD, AB is 20 and AD is 12. Okay, so we have a parallelogram ABCD. AB is 20 and AD is 12. Okay. Bisector of A meets DC at E. Bisector of A. Angle bisector. So if this is X, this is X. Bisector of angle A meets DC at E. And BC produced at F. BC produced meets at F. It's a parallelogram. Fine. Find the length of CF. A. How will you do it? Check. Fine. See, this is a Z formation. So in a Z formation, by interior alternate angles, this will be X. This is going to be my statement number one. Alternate angles. Uske karan, this is X. Second, this will also be X. Statement number two, vertically opposite angles. Oh, now look at this step. Oh, sir, awesome, you are intelligent. Can you see this Z? I know that. Tell me something which I don't know. Can you see something? Z, the big Z. Yes. So, if this is X, wouldn't this also be X? Step number 3, statement number 3, interior alternate angles. That means this triangle becomes an isosceles triangle then. Triangle CEF is an isosceles triangle. So both angles are equal. I would rather say both sides are equal. So if this is A, this is also A. Therefore, CE is equal to CF is equal to A. Okay. Even ADE as an isosceles triangle. ADE is also an isosceles triangle. So if this is 12, this is also 12. Ye complete package is 20. So AB is equals to DC, which is equals to 20. The entire DC, 12 plus A. DC can be written as 12 plus A is 20. So A will be equal to 8. So I get the value, the length of CF as 8 centimeters. Okay, listen. XX base angles equal. It is an isosceles triangle. Sides are equal. 12, 12. XX base angles equal. Sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. A. If this is 20, this entire is 20. So 12 plus A is 20, A is 8. Last question for this exercise, 10th. Okay. A diagram given to me is somewhat like this. It's a parallelogram again. Ninety out here. This central part is y, 90. This is x, 90. X is to y is 2 is to 1. Let the common multiple be a. Because you can't use x, na? X is already used. So y will be 1a, x will be 2a. Add them. In this figure, it's a quadrilateral, na? Four-sided figure. So can I say y plus 90 plus x plus 90 is equal to 360. Y ke badle 1a plus 90 instead of x 2a plus 90 is 360. A plus 2a makes it 3a, 180, a will be 60 degrees. So obviously this is going to be 120 degrees and this is going to be 60 degrees. Okay, now what? It's a parallelogram. Come on, if this is 120 by a C formation, co-interior angles, yeah, they are parallel to each other. So, if this is 120 degrees, by C formation, wouldn't this be 60? Opposite angles are equal, 60 and 120. Okay, so I found this entire as 120 with a C formation. This plus this is 180. Ye 60 milega. Opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. 60, 120. So, with this we complete our B exercise. See, where many sums are omitted, you don't have to solve all of them. I'll just solve a few. Solve only those with me. It's alright. Alright guys, see exercise question number 2. Now the question is, the first question from my side. In a parallelogram ABCD, diagonal BD is a bisector of the angle D and D. Prove that the parallelogram is a rhombus. So, first question from my side in the C exercise. Listen, just look out here. Book mein dekhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Chal, it's a parallelogram. It's a parallelogram. Diagonal BD is the angle bisector. It's given. Angle bisector. Now, before that, my bad. I'm sorry. Sorry. Can I say, since it is a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal and parallel. Itna to mante ho. Opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay, this is an angle bisector. Do you know, in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. These both are equal. So, if this is 2x, this will also be 2x. Let me break it as x and x. So, this will also be x and x. Because please, parallelogram mein, ye pura angle and this entire angle has to be equal. I named it as 2x, broken it as xx, same. Sunna. Aren't these two angles equal? If these two angles are equal in this triangle, I think it becomes an isosceles triangle. This becomes an isosceles triangle. So these two sides will also be equal. I will say, since this is equal to this, sides are going to be equal. So DC has to be equal to BC. And also, these two are equal. Base angles of isosceles triangle. So this becomes isosceles. These two sides are also equal. So I can say AB is equal to AD. But DC and AB are equal, opposite sides of a parallelogram. Basically, all of them are equal. So AB equal to AD equal to BC equal to DC. All sides are equal and it's a parallelogram. So in a parallelogram, if all sides are equal, it has to be a dash. Rhombus. Okay, hence proved. So in the exam, how do you write? Okay, decoration, I told you, try by yourself. My aim, objective is to make you understand, get your concepts thorough and clear. Awesome. Check, first step. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. First. Second step. This entire angle and this entire angle will be same. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. What up? Third. Agar ye 2x hai, 2x, it's a bisector. They have given me. It's a bisector. XX, XX. Fourth step. This becomes an isosceles triangle. Adjacent sides are equal. Sides are equal. Basically, all sides are equal. It's a rhombus. Let's go with the next sum from my side. Okay, a diagram given to me. Second question from my side, yeah. In the C exercise. Diagram looks like this. It's again a parallelogram. You have A, D, A, B, C, D, and there is a point E out here. Join. This is the diagram. Question mein bola hai, A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. You have to prove that, AB is 2BC. ये प्रूफ करना है AB is 2 times BC. Okay, how? Check. How do I do it? समझ नहीं रहा है. Anything else is given in the question? No, nothing, nothing. Oh, of course it is given. Oh, wow. It is given these two are equal and these two are equal. It is an angle bisector. AE is an angle bisector given. So if I call it as X, this will be X. Y, this will be Y. I can see that this is parallel lines. I can see a Z formation. Z formation. So this will be X. Interior alternate angles. This is also a Z formation. This will be Y. Interior alternate angles. So obviously, yes. Ye do sides equal hai. It's a parallelogram. But even these two sides are equal. So basically all four, it's an isosceles also na. X, X, base angles equal, so sides are equal. Converse of isosceles triangles. Sides are equal because base angles are equal. And ye bhi equal hai. So AD equal to BC. Reason? Opposite angles of a parallelogram. But AD is also equal to DE. And BC is equal to EC. Converse of isosceles triangle theorem. Converse of isosceles triangle. That means all are equal, sub equal. So AD equal to BC equal to DE equal to EC. Hence proved, almost proved. AB is equals to DC. AB is equals to DC. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. So can I say AB is equals to DC, right? DC can be written as DE. 2 times DE. Are DE plus EC? But they all are equal. DE, EC, BC, AD all are equal. Hence, AB is equal to 2 times BC. That's it. Okay. Next question from my side. Okay. Prove that bisectors of interior angles of a parallelogram form a rectangle. But before that, prove that I am writing a statement. Bisectors of opposite angles of parallelogram are parallel. Okay. Bisectors of opposite angles of parallelogram. Let's see how do we do this. This is a parallelogram. Bisector. let's take ABCD. This is a bisector, it's an angle bisector. XX angle ko bisect karta hai, bola hai. Bisectors of opposite angles of a parallelogram. So this will also be XX. We have to prove that AM and CN are parallel. To prove AM is parallel to CN. Okay. How? Same like this sum only. First step, it's a parallelogram. So opposite sides are equal and parallel, opposite angles are equal. Half half. Same. XX, XX. That's why. This is a bisector, so obviously X, Z formation, interior alternate angles. X, Z formation, interior alternate angles. X. Okay. So, obviously, if this is X, can I say by linear pair, 180 minus X? By linear pair, 180 minus X. Okay, approved. Can I say in the internal figure, in the interior figure, that is in AMCN, this one, opposite angles are equal, opposite sides are equal. Finish, game is over. Therefore, AMCN is a what? It's a parallelogram. Opposite angles are equal and opposite sides are equal. Therefore, this is also a parallelogram and I can say AM. Or you can also say that it becomes a C formation. Converse of co-interior angles, M plus C, angle AMC plus angle NCM is 180. Okay, this plus this is 180, na XX cut ho jayega. And if it is 180 by converse of co-interior angles, by converse of co-interior angles, the lines AM and parallel to CM. The two lines are parallel. Okay. Next question. Question number 4 from my side. Okay. I'm writing a statement. Prove that interior angles of parallelogram form a rectangle. Prove that interior angles of a rectangle, they form a parallelogram. Okay, fine. Bisectors of interior angles. Prove that bisectors of interior angles of a rectangle form a parallelogram. So first thing, it is a rectangle given. Okay, so we have a rectangle which is given. Bisectors of interior angles, sabke angle bisector. Okay, this figure inside is a rectangle, that's what I have to prove. Okay. This is the figure. Okay, how do we do this sum? Now, it's an angle bisector, so obviously 90 has to be angle bisector. So 45 each, angle bisector. Fine. Now, in this triangle, obviously this will be 90, angle sum property. This will be 90, each angle will be 90. So it can be a square also, it can be a rectangle also. This plus, this is 180, angle sum property. That's how I get 90. Okay. What next? These both are going to be equal. This is going to be 90. Fine. These both are going to be equal. And this is going to be 90. Okay. Now what? How will you prove that the two opposite sides are equal? How are you going to prove that? Come on, try. Angles to ho gaye na? Okay, this side इट्स अ रेक्टेंगल, सो ये साइड इक्वल है, राइट. सेकेंड थिंग, एक मिनट, आई हैव टू प्रूव इट इज अ इट्स अ पैरेललोग्राम. वी हैव प्रूव्ड इट. सिंस दिस इज 90 90 90 90, ऑब्वियसली लाइंस आर गोइंग टू बी परपेंडिकुलर. इफ लाइंस आर परपेंडिकुलर, ऑपोजिट साइड्स हैव टू बी पैरेलल. अरे इन अ रेक्टेंगल दिस इज bisectors of interior angles, this is an angle bisector, 45 45 45, plus this plus 45 in this triangle, let me call this as M. So each angle inside will be 90. 90 means opposite lines are perpendicular, sorry, adjacent lines are perpendicular, opposite will be parallel. It's a parallelogram because opposite lines, opposite sides are parallel to each other. Because each angle is 90, ना? Common sense है. अगर adjacent 90 हो गए, adjacent 90 होंगे, तो opposite have to be parallel to each other, ना? Then only it becomes a parallelogram. Okay? So they are just thoughtful sums. You have to just think, not that difficult questions. Okay? We are going to take two more sets. Around 12 sums we will solve for you. Hey guys, moving on with the next question. The question is your 10th sum. Oh, 9th question. The question is, in a parallelogram ABCD, the bisector of angle A meets DC at point P. Let's draw this much. Itna to draw kare. Yes? So, in a parallelogram ABCD, yes, the bisector of angle A meets DC at P. Okay, meets DC at point P. This is an angle bisector. So obviously they both are equal. Then what? AB is equal to 2AD. AB is 2 times AD. Oh, okay. Obviously it's a parallelogram, so opposite sides are equal. So I can say AB is equal to 2 times AD. That's given to me. Yeah, that's given part in the question. Fine. Prove that BP bisects B. You have to prove that this is also an angle bisector, that these both are equal. Alright. And you have to prove that angle APB is 90. This angle we need to find out and prove that it is 90 degrees. Okay. Now, how am I going to go about with this sum? Can I start this way? Listen. AB is twice AD. I'll check it. Yes, AB is twice AD. Now what? Can I say according to interior alternate angles, it's a parallelogram. So by a Z formation, this is going to be X. This is going to be X, obviously. Yeah, if this is X, this has to be X. That is first step. Step number one, what up? Now, triangle DAP. It is an isosceles triangle. See, both base angles are equal. So obviously, DP is equal to AD. Triangle DAP is going to be an isosceles triangle because the base angles are equal. So I can say AD is equal to PD. Base angles of isosceles triangle. Okay. But you know that AC is equal to DC. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. AC is equal to DC. But what is DC? What is DC? DC, okay, this one. DC is equal to DP plus PC. Now listen to me very carefully, very cautiously. Out here, if I call this angle as Y, so obviously by a Z formation, this is also going to be Y. Isn't that obvious? Okay, sounds good. What next? This is AB is equal to DC. AB is equal to DC. But AB is 2AD. AB is 2 times AD. And DC can be written as DP plus PC. also AD is equal to PD. So if you shift out here, you will get AD is equals to PC. DP and AD are equal. So if you shift out here, it will be 2AD minus DP, which is minus AD. So AD is also equal to PC. So basically AD is equal to DP is equal to PC. Finish. This also becomes an isosceles triangle. So base angles have to be equal. I would rather say it is converse of isosceles triangle, because sides are equal. That makes me say that the angles are equal. So first part proved that PD is the angle bisector. So therefore PD is the angle bisector. So first thing, what I have done, rule number one, XX, Z formation. Rule number two, it is an isosceles triangle, two sides are equal. Rule number three, AB is given 2 times AD, it's given. But can I say AD is equal to BC and is equal to DP? All are equal. So on solving, DC can be written as DP plus PC. So 1 DP goes on other side, you get DP is equal to PC, which is equal to AD, which is equal to BC. Basically, all are equal. All 4 are equal. So if these sides are equal, can I say even these angles by converse of isosceles, they are equal. So this also becomes an isosceles triangle. So I have proved that yes, this is your angle bisector, B bisects BP. BP is bisected by angle B, by this ray BP. Now you have to prove that this angle is 90 degrees. This is 90. Ye proof karna hai. Okay, how am I going to solve that? Can I say that it's a C formation? Can you see? Obviously, lines are parallel. So in a C formation, we can claim that 2x plus 2y is equals to 180. That is 2x plus 2y is equal to 180 divided by 2, x plus y 90 milega. Correct? In this C formation. Co-interior angles. Okay. Also in triangle ABP, can I say x plus y plus angle P is 180 angle sum property? But x plus y is 90. So 90 plus your angle P is 180. Hence I have proved that angle P is 90. So we proved that the angle P is also 90. Nice question. Let's go with the next question from my side. Okay, check this out. Okay, the question is, point M and N are taken on diagonal AC of a parallelogram ABCD. Okay, so we have a parallelogram ABCD. M and N are taken on diagonal AC. This is your diagonal AC. Somewhere there is M, somewhere there is N. I don't know where. AM is equal to CN. Prove that BMDN is a parallelogram. Okay, so I can say that M is a point and N is a point on AC. On this diagonal AC, we have somewhere M and somewhere we have N, right? Somewhere M and somewhere N. Join it. If I join DM and BN, right? You join this also. Yes. And it's given that AM is equal to CN, given. That's given to you. AM is equal to CN. Proof kya karna hai that this DMBN is a parallelogram. That's what you need to prove. Theek hai na? DMBN, I'll just check. Yeah, BMDN. BMDN is a parallelogram. Wonderful question. Lot of thought involved in the question. Listen, since this is a diagonal in a parallelogram, if I say yes, अगर मैंने इसको x लिया, they both will be x, complete package will be 2x, even this is going to be x and x, complete will be 2x. Obviously, by a z formation also, you can say they are the same things, interior alternate angles, yes, because it is a parallelogram, right students? Okay, now, in a triangle, I'm going to use congruency test. In this triangle and in this triangle, I'm going to prove these two triangles congruent. Obviously, parallelogram mein opposite sides are equal. So, in triangle DMA, yes, in triangle DMA and triangle D ke saamne aata hai B, B and C. First thing, AM is equal to CN given. Dot 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 given. Second, angle DAM is equal to angle BCN. NCB. It is interior alternate angles. Okay. Third, AD is equal to BC, opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. So I can say that by side angle side test, SAS Sasuma test, the two triangles are congruent. So triangle DMA is congruent to triangle BNC. The reason is SAS test. Okay, once it is congruent, can I say that DM is equal to BN? DM is equal to Bano. The reason is corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. And also I can say that this angle is going to be equal to this angle. Angle DMA is equal to angle CNB or BNC. Same reason. Okay. So I have already proved a couple of things. First, I proved that this and this are equal. Acha, agar bahar ka angle equal hai, toh obviously inside angles will also be equal. So obviously, can I say the inner two angles will also be equal, linear pair. So angle DMN will also be equal to angle BNM. Reason is statement number 6 se mila. By using linear pair, perfect. And then I can prove very simply that these two triangles are congruent by side angle common side. Side angle side, again SAS test. And definitely you can say that yes, itna nahi bhi karna hai, directly you can say, isn't this a Z formation? Isn't this a Z formation? Obviously, Z formation ka ulta. Are Z formation is possible only and only when the lines are parallel. Varna Z formation is not possible. These angles are going to be equal on a single condition if these two lines are parallel. So I will say this is true. It is true only when DM is parallel to BN. The reason is converse of interior alternate angles. Why converse? Because parallel diya nahi hai. It's not given. Hum log proof kar rahe hai. We are proving it to be parallel because it shows a Z formation. And how did it show a Z formation? Because of the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. So we went in a reverse psychology. That since the angles are equal, lines have to be parallel. And it is a rule. If one set of opposite side is equal and parallel, it is a parallelogram. So if one set, one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel, then we can say that it is, it matlab DMBN is a parallelogram. Please remember this. Okay, wonderful question. Okay, this was the first question out here. Second question. Okay, going on with the next question. Okay guys, next set of three questions. Question is, in a diagram which we have almost seen, we are acquainted with this diagram. Yes, we have seen such a diagram twice perhaps. A, B, C, D, P, these both are equal and these both are equal. It's given. Prove karna hai, and it's a parallelogram also. So obviously in a parallelogram, opposite sides are also equal. But basically dekhne jaye na, all four are equal. Are yaar, if these two are equal and these two are equal, obviously 5, 5, 5 and 5 all are equal. Right? Sounds good. Okay. So now I can say that AP bisects angle A. A simple question. Can I start that in triangle ADP, in triangle ADP, it is an isosceles triangle. So obviously the base angles are equal. Even out here, the base angles are equal. Converse of isosceles triangle. Yes. And it's a parallelogram also. So by a Z formation, this will also be X. By a Z formation, this will also be Y. Hence, I have proved that AP is the angle bisector of A, BP is the angle bisector of B. And you have to prove that angle DAP plus angle CBP, which is X plus Y, is equal to angle APB. Oh, it's so simple. Can I say angle PAB plus angle PBA plus angle PBPA is 180. Angle sum property. Now PAB is X plus Y plus angle APB is equal to 180. So angle APB is 180 minus bracket X plus Y, which is going to be 90. Because by a C formation, 2X plus 2Y is 180 co-interior angles. X plus Y is 90. So on substitution, you get angle APB is 90. And yes, 90, isn't it X plus Y? Oh, come on. APB is 90, and what is 90? Go backwards. X plus Y. And X is also DAP. And Y is also CBD. Hence proof. What you've done is very simple. Very simple. Two sides are equal. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Eventually all are equal. Okay. Base angles are same, base angles are equal, converse of isosceles. Parallelogram mein Z formation, X, X. So basically this is angle bisector, this is also angle bisector. Yes. Tino ka addition is 180. So you get answer as 90. You get the value of P, angle, this angle, you get it as 90 degrees. But what is 90? Go backwards. 90 is nothing but X plus Y. So instead of 90, next step I rewrote it as X plus Y. This time, can I take X as this angle and Y as this angle? You get the answer. Next question, 12th. ABCD is a square. Okay. A is joined to point P on BC. P is some point, kidhar hai mujhe bhi nahi pata hai. A is joined to a point in BC and D is joined to a point Q on AB. D is joined to a point Q on AB. if AP equal to DQ, AP is equals to DQ given. Prove that they are perpendicular to each other. Matlab, you have to prove that this angle between them is 90 degrees. Let's begin. Okay, it is a square, so each angle has 90 degree at its vertex. Can I prove the two triangles congruent? So in triangle, this one, okay, focus on the diagram, and another is this triangle. Yeah, these two triangles prove them congruent. In triangle DAQ, and triangle DA, that was a bigger side of a square and then the smaller version. So it is going to be ABP, bigger side of a square and then a smaller version. The naming is very crucial. Isme kaise gaya? Side of a square and then the small part. So obviously this will be complete side of a square and then the small part. AD is equal to AB. Sides of a square are equal. All sides are equal. That's the first part. Second point, you can say that DQ is equal to AP given. And angle DAQ is equal to angle ABP. It's an angles of a square. You can say given. Therefore, triangle DAQ is congruent to triangle ABP. Now guys, when two sides and one 90 degree angle is equal, and one of the given sides, one of the equal sides is congruent, is equal, it is RHS test. It is not SS, SAS. RHS theorem. What is that? If two sides are equal and one of the equal side is a hypotenuse, though equal sides may say a compulsory is a hypotenuse, okay, and it is a 90 degree. So can I see it is RHS theorem? अच्छा एक बार आई हैव प्रूव दैट पार्ट कैन आई से दैट दिस एंगल विल बी इक्वल द क्यू एंगल विल बी इक्वल टू पी एंगल सीपीसीटीसी कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग पार्ट्स ऑफ कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्रायंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट ओके सो आई नेम दिस एज एक्स दिस विल आल्सो बी एक्स सो माय नेक्स्ट स्टेप विल बी एंगल क्यू इज इक्वल टू एंगल पी दैट इज ए क्यू डी is equal to angle AQD, AQD, look at the pattern, BPA, which is, I call it as X. Now what? I want to find out this angle. Mujhe prove karna hai that this is 90. Almost done. Isko A naam do. Let that angle at the center be A. Now, in triangle ABP, focus on this entire triangle. Can you see? If this is x, this is 90, wouldn't this much be 90 minus x? Come on here. If this is x, this is 90, this angle, this part, angle sum property will be 90 minus x. And finally, in this triangle, you can say a plus x plus 90 minus x is equals to 180. Angle sum property. X cancels. A is equals to 180 minus 90. You will get A as 90 degrees. Hence proved that the angle between DQ and AP, it is a perpendicular. It's 90 degrees. Next question. 30th. So what we did was we proved two triangles congruent. By corresponding sides or angles, we got these two angles equal. X 90, this angle will be 90 minus X. And tino ka addition in a small triangle is going to be 180. Hence, I get A as 90 degrees. Okay, the next question. Okay, in a quadrilateral ABCD, AB is equals to AD and CB is equals to CD. Okay, so in a quadrilateral, how does it look? Even I don't know. So ABCD, you join. It is given AB is equals to AD and CD is equals to CB. This is given to me. Prove that AC bisects angle BAD. AC bisects angle BAD. It's a very simple question. I can solve the sum orally. I'm going to select two triangles. First, ADC and triangle ABC. In triangle ADC and ABC, AD is equal to AB, given. CD is equal to CB, given. Okay. AC is equal to AC, common side. So can we claim that the two triangles are congruent by SSS test of congruency? And once they are congruent, can I say this angle is equal to this angle, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent? This angle is equal to this angle, right? You can say that, hai na? Okay, so if this is x, this is x, if this is y, this is also y, correct? Easy. Now take, this was the first part, okay? Prove the two triangles, this one and the bottom one, proving them congruent, purple and the orange one. SSS test, okay? Equal and a common sign. Now take the smaller versions of triangle. Take this triangle and this triangle. So now I'm going to take triangle A, let me call it as O, AOD, and triangle AOB. In these two triangles, first, AO is equal to AO, common side. AO is equal to AO, common side. Perfect. AD is equals to AB, given. And these two angles I just proved by CPCTC that they are equal. So by side, angle, side, by SAS test, can I say the two triangles are congruent? And if they are congruent, obviously this angle will be equal to this angle. These two angles will be equal. CPCTC corresponding parts, again the same thing. And isn't this a linear pair? This forms a linear pair, 180 degrees. So can we say A plus A is 180, 2A is 180, you get A as 90 degrees. That's it, hence proved. Right. So a simple question, two different sets of triangles had to be proven as congruent, which gave you the answer. And ek bar isko congruent proof kiya by corresponding parts, two angles were equal. And if two angles were equal, can I say, yeah, this forms a linear pair. This both sum up, add up, giving me how much? How much? 180. So you get A as 90, and we have proved that it is a right angled triangle. It is 90 degree, this one. So go through this, and now we are proceeding with the last set of three questions to wind up the chapter. Next question, the last set of three questions for the chapter to get over. Okay, the question is, in a case of a parallelogram, prove that the bisectors of any two adjacent sides intersect at 90. Guys, it is a parallelogram. Bisectors of adjacent sides. Adjacent means bajuwala. This is a bisector. It's an angle bisector. And this one. This is also an angle bisector. Okay. You have to prove that this is 90. You have to prove that N is 90. Ho gaya samya. It is a parallelogram. So in a parallelogram, first thing, that there is a something called as a C formation. C formation means this plus this is 180 co-interior angles. So can I say 2x plus 2y is equals to 180? The reason is co-interior angles. Divide by 2, x plus y is 180 divided by 2, which is 90. After this, can I say in this triangle, in triangle ABM, can we see the sum of all three angles, that is x plus y plus angle M, has to be 180 degrees? The reason is angle sum property, and this was co-interior angles, allied angles, C formation, right? But you know x plus y is 90. So can I say 90 plus angle M is 180? And we have proved that angle M is 90 degrees, and that's it. So we have proved that they intersect at the two angle bisectors of adjacent bajuwala sides of a parallelogram intersect at 90. Okay, going on to the next question. Okay. The next question is a diagram given to me. Something like this. We have this and we have this. ABCD, okay. Okay, A, this is B. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so these lines are equal and parallel. And PQRS is a parallelogram. Okay, so again, these parallel and these parallel. This is given. These are two parallelograms. Okay, angle D is 120. Angle Q is 70. Find the value of X, which is out here. This is your X. Now, obviously, by vertically opposite angles, even this is going to be X, common sense. Vertically opposite angles. Okay, a very simple question. Four step sum. That's it. Step number one. In a parallelogram, which I am drawing with orange, in a parallelogram ABCD, yes, can I say opposite angles are equal? In a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So this is going to be 120. First thing. In a parallelogram, which I am shading with purple, this parallelogram, can I use the C formation? C formation means co-interior angles. This angle plus 70 is equal to 180. So I will say by co-interior angles, this is going to be 110. Right? Okay. Finally, can I use linear pair? Linear pair, this will be 60. And this is going to be 70. Linear pair, both of them. So I can say angle sum property, x plus 60 plus 70 is equals to 180, x plus 130 is equals to 180, you get x as 50 degrees. So the rules are as follows. First, in the left side of parallelogram, opposite angles are equal, 120, 120. By a linear pair, this becomes 60. Right side parallelogram, 70 by C formation, co-interior angles, this plus this is 180, ye 110 milega, and can I say 110 linear pair, this is 70. Sum of all three has to be 180, angle sum property. Last question for this chapter. The question is, diagram diya hai, okay. You've given a diagram to me, something like this. Alright. This is given to me and this is given to me. We have 56. Then we have ABCD. FE. and DCFE is a square. This is a square, all sides are equal and each angle makes 90 because it is a square. Second thing, ABCD is a rhombus. Rhombus may be all sides are equal. So basically all of them are equal. Are this is a common side to a square and a rhombus. So if this is 5, 5, 5, 5, rhombus will also be 5, 5, all of them. So basically all sides are equal. Okay. ABC is 56. Sure. First, find DAE. DAE, they are asking you this angle. Let me call it as X. Can I say DAE is an isosceles triangle? So obviously this will also be X. First thing. Rhombus is a type of a parallelogram. Rhombus kya hai? It's a type of a parallelogram. And in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. In a parallelogram, if this is 56, isn't this obvious? Okay, this will also be 56. And this is 90, obviously. So can I start in triangle EDA? In triangle EDA, x plus complete D. Array, angle sum property, tino ka addition 180 hoga. 90 and 56 is your D. Plus 2x is equals to 180. So 2x makes it 180 minus 146. 2x is equals to 4. Kitna hoga? 34. You'll get x as 17 degrees. Second part. What next? Can anyone help me out? Okay. What is asked? FEA. FEA. Okay, it is this angle. Obviously, it's going to be 90 minus x. FEA is nothing but 90 minus x. 90 and this is x because this much part is cut out. So, 90 minus 17. Your answer is going to be 63. 73. Beg your pardon. 73. Okay, the next they are asking me is AEC. You will have to join this. They are asking me this angle. Okay, now AEC. Okay, this one. Now, how am I going to, on earth, I'm going to find out this angle? This is from the back part, it's coming at E and opening at C. Let's see how do we calculate it. So, ye bahut hi sochne wala hai. Before that, I'm going to find CAE. CAE, this one. How? Check. It's a rhombus. Rhombus kya hai? A type of parallelogram hai. So there is a C formation. C formation means 56 plus this entire is 180. So wouldn't this entire be are C formation yaar, C na yaar. C this way. Co-interior angles. So this is going to be 180 minus 56. That makes it 124. And a diagonal will divide it into two halves. 62, 62. Diagonal hamesha do part mein divide karta hai. Even in a square, a diagonal will bisect the 90 into 45 and 45. Okay. Acha, by Z formation, this complete will be 62. Complete. So, CAE is going to be 62, the complete 62 by a Z formation. See the Z. 62 minus X. That is going to be 62 minus 17, because x is 17. You get 45. So CAE is 45, and the last one, this angle. Angle some property in this triangle. That is 45 plus 62, complete package, 45 plus 62, plus this much, this is 45, plus this angle E. So I will write out here, 45 plus 62 plus 45 plus that angle CEA, angle sum property 180. This is 152 plus angle CEA is 180. You get angle CEA as 180 minus 52, which is going to be 28 degrees. So guys, with this we completed. It was a very difficult question, a very thoughtful sum, brilliant question. You just go through this sum again, you will not understand in one explanation. You will have to rewind my video, this one. Think. So with this guys, we complete our chapter called rectilinear figures or polygons. It was a difficult chapter at the end, though. Starting was simple, midway puzzles were okayish, end way it was difficult. Usually end wale sums, they don't ask it in the school exam. Most majority of the schools, they cancel it, but it is my duty for y'all to do these sums, right? So go through this chapter. We shall soon proceed with the next. We'll be right back.